my best friend loud when only rumors talk on crowded subway.
In sophomore Spanish, I was in the front of the class, but my mind was too behind to catch up.
In ninth grade English, I was wondering if anybody could smell my shoes from across the room because my socks weren't clean.
Sixth grade English, retracing my sister's sketchbook instead of my cursive learning workbook. I never learned through textbooks.
I was in a polo shirt wearing khaki pants. My dad had a corporate job out of town. I knew I didn't belong.
I fell asleep during my Spanish exam. My motivation was as weak as my GPA.
I was sitting in biology thinking about sleep I missed the night before.
I would sleep in English because prayers were paragraphs I could never write down. They could never find out what home was really like.
I slept in math because we had moved to a new hotel the night before.
I would dream if I could eat. When I came home,
I would wonder why my school was nothing like Glee.
Why I never felt ready to talk in the classroom.
My attention span had bad batteries.
Broken wires falling out of my ears. Screws and nails stuck inside my ego.
My attention span left in dark lockers filled with high school drama.
Sat in the principal's chair because my sister picked herself up better than I did.
Then, my mother's tears watered my ambition. My sophomore English teacher told me that I was a star, so I started planting my goals on the moon.
Then, a poet gave a microphone to an 11-year-old horror story that was too scared to open the door.
Then, at a library writing workshop, I strangled my problems out of pencils to erase the typos that came into my life without punctuation.
Then, my aunt stared me in the eyes as she reached my 16-year-old soul. Her voice as loud as a thousand butterflies. The last 2 years of high school ain't no joke!
I guess that's why you didn't laugh.
There's nothing funny about kids getting thrown into a Hunger Games of the world.
But ACT test makers who thrive in the struggle as entertainment.
Or scholarship forms that I'm not being taught how to fill out.
It's not a joke! Life ain't no war game!
And the rest of your life off Instagram likes.
And better selfie angles won't cut you a bigger check.
It's serious out there. White collar, top dollar.
Black leather chair sitting.
Correct email sending. Serious out there.
The only way is up. I'm ready. Rise and grind.
Instead of searching for cloud nine, I gave my gravity a reality check.
Newton's law of motion.
An object in motion will stay in motion unless acted on by an outside force.
So if I keep moving, stay focused, stay plugged in and engaged.
Waking up at 6 a.m.
Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
Wings look like notebook paper. Feathers are words and fragments. Leaking a story with your eyes squeezed shut.
We got enough electricity to leak the world in shock.
I'm trying to put college degree burns on the back of my throat.
Work now, play never. Pay attention in class, but the future of your family depends on it. We got a mom who never graduated. We got a father that can't dream. We got a community rooting you on. We got a older sister to catch up to. And the only way you are still standing
is a dying grandmother who can't breathe enough to tell you how much she loves you.
On the prayers of your family members.
It's with a backbone you blacksmith by yourself.
It's the lessons your teachers gave you.